Hello everyone and welcome to the inbox review of this 172 scale Russian 5th generation fighter SU-57 from Zvezda. Okay, let's start by looking at the gift box. I apologize that the box looks a little bit messed up. It had a quite rough travel, and no styrene was harmed, so everything is good. Okay, so if we look at the top side, we have the nice illustration of the aircraft, and on the sides here we have a paint call out in actually Tamiya and Zvezda. That's nice. I think they used to have Humbrol or something like that, but now they seem to have chosen Tamiya instead, which is good. And we have some information about the kit, 172 scale and 122 parts. And the length is 29.5 centimeters of the finished model. We also have some information on the side, nothing interesting. We have some advertisement for other aircrafts in 172 scale. And if we look at the backside, we have it looks like a built-up model. You can see some evidence of actual scale modeling going on here, so I don't think it's a CAD model or a render. Yeah, that looks nice. It's interesting to see if the nozzles are poseable, but we will try to figure out that when we look at the instructions and the sprues. So yeah, our kit number 7319. Okay, so let's open the box. And since it's a Zvezda, there are actually two boxes. So there are one side opening box and one box in corrugated paper, and that is good because I think that this box actually saved the model from permanent damage due to transit. Okay, so we have a bag with two sprues. We have clear parts and pilot figure. Same bag. I'm not so happy about that. I think they should separate the clear parts from the other sprue. And we have a bag with 1, 2, 3, 4 sprues. And we have some safety information, the assembly instructions, the decal sheet, and the paint cola, which actually is in color, which is very nice. Okay, so let's open up the bags and we have a look at what's inside. Okay, so let's start with the upper half of the fuselage and wings. And there are very delicate panel lines. That looks really nice, actually. I think it's an improvement compared to what I've seen from Zvezda earlier. For example, the Yak 130 that I built a while ago. There is something that looks like a small sink mark, though. But that's... That's not on the other side, so I guess that was wasn't a big issue. And the cockpit parts looks really nice, very crisp and well-defined surfaces, and there is seems to be a little bit of a rough texture to the plastic, but I think that's okay. Right, on the inside everything looks good, I think. No excess ejection pin marks or anything. Everything seems to be tuned in the tooling. So yeah, that looks nice. And we have the bottom half, and that looks really good as well. Same fine texture and panel lines. Yeah. There's not much going on in the in the nose landing gear bay though. I don't know if that's supposed to be clean like that, or yeah, maybe you want to do something about that, I don't know. It's it's an opportunity to if it's possible to find reference photos of the nose landing gear bay, then I guess you could detail that yourself. Okay, so if we look at the second bag, we have a lot of sprues here. Let's start with the first one. These are actually two identical ones, with burner cans, external fuel drop tanks, pylons, and air-to-air missile. And yeah, this is for one engine, I guess, since there are two of them. Oh, maybe there seem to be some small damage here on that one. Yeah. One thing that I'm not so very fond of is when they have a cross with sprue gates in the middle like that. It's a pain to clean that up, and there are also a lot of small details, so you don't want just to, you have to be very careful when you do that. So I'm curious why they have two nozzles, but maybe there are two sets for, if they're not poseable, but you can sort of select which one you choose. Ah, I have to check that out when I get to the assembly instructions. But the details are really, really nice. This looks really good. Yeah, and there you have the turbine. Yep. And the afterburner. Yeah, that looks really nice, I must say. And this is really, really nice. It will probably be a pain to cut that from the sprue tree, but yeah, if you're careful, worst case you have to saw it just to make sure that you don't break anything with a sprue cutter. Okay, so this one was identical. Next up we have two identical sprues as well, and we have a quite nice set of weapons, I must say. That is really nice. And we have a big sprue here with a lot of details for the engine and the undercarriage. And there are some really interesting things going on here. Look at the landing gear. Very, very nicely done. And all those small parts. You have to be very careful when you cut them from the sprue tree. And there is also a sort of rim or lining for the main landing gear base. And all the surface details looks really nice with the panel lines, and here we have a ladder. Okay, so here's the sort of the steps for the ladder. Really nice. And we have the ejection seat. That looks really nice as well. So yeah, an awful lot of small delicate parts here. So yeah, it's definitely not the beginner's build, this. That looks really nice. Oh, here's the cockpit tub and the instrument panel. I guess there is since this is a fifth generation fighter, everything is computerized, so this full glass cockpit. So it's probably not much detail painting going on in the cockpit tub. And we have this Ziploc bag with the clear parts. And they seem to have survived the trip and looks really nice. There seem to be some kind of texture on the inside of the glass. Really cool. No, it's on the outside. So it's some kind of texture that you will probably have to paint that area, and then the texture will sort of show. Yep, this looks really nice. I think I put it back in the bag by itself from now on. And we have a small pilot that can choose from standing pose beside the aircraft or a sitting pilot. So if we look at the decals, they are Zvezda quality, I believe, lots of technical stencils. And I guess these are walkways and oh, so okay, so that is one big piece with a Russian star and the dashed lines. Oh, here we have some sort of metallic meshes for I guess for air intakes and things like that. Really nice. We can even see that it has come some kind of honeycomb pattern. Really cool. And the decals seem to be in register, as far as I can see. And here is for some decals for the cockpit. Yeah, there is some things going on here, so I guess you can you have some kind of detail in detailing, or at least some spots of color in the cockpit. Okay, so assembly instructions. Some information in Russian and English on the front first page here, and also some options for how you should pose the fins and actuators if you are building it gear up or gear down. There's something in Russian here. I guess that they are saying that this part isn't included in the kit, because it's not, or at least not in my in the kit I got. Okay, so let's continue here. And yep, we have a sprue call out, some modeling tips, and then we start with the actual build. Let's see if I can place this so it's in shot. And it's the usual Zvezda. If you have built a couple of Zvezda kits, then you know that there are things going on the side here. So you have to pay attention to both what's going on here and the numbered parts, because there are references to. This part is that. So this is assembly 1A. This is 1A, but you are following 1, 2, 3, 4, and so forth. So it's a bit, you have to be a little bit careful when you read instructions, so you don't miss a step. And you start looking for some part, you know, on the sprues that are actually a sub-assembly. So it's not a part. Okay, enough about that. But the assembly seems quite easy here. Yeah, you have to take up a slot here for the stand if you have one. And okay, so there seems to be two versions for the okay, you have version 1 and 2 here, so it's depending on if you're building the aircraft gear up or gear down, you have to choose different nozzles, and so that's the version reference to the versions. So yeah, so it seems pretty straightforward here. And on the back side here we have the undercarriage, weapons, and so forth. The ladder and the pilot. And we also have the call out for the technical stencils. All right. So here we have two different versions. This one can probably be a bit challenging. I'm sure that they, if it's not available already, there is probably some aftermarket masking set for this. And yeah, you have to use the same for, or a similar one for that. Okay, so there are two versions, one in sort of blue and one in some kind of green color, which seems a little bit odd, but it's probably correct. So what is my impression of this kit? I think that this is a much, much better kit than the Hobby Boss one. And of course the Hobby Boss kit is a bit old now, and there is also an old tooling from Zvezda on all this, but this is the new one, and everything looks fantastic. The only thing I saw that was an issue was a couple of dents on the burner cans, but that could be caused by the transportation problem I encountered. So I shouldn't really blame Zvezda for that. And there was a small sink mark on the top side, caused by the where we attached the main landing gear. But there are fantastic details and some really, really delicate and nice parts that will probably be a bit of a struggle to get together and to clean. But speaking of cleaning, I didn't see much flash or any burr or anything. Everything seemed very, very crisp. So I think this will be a really, really nice Sukhoi 57 when it's finished. Probably not the easiest kit, but I don't know. If you're just careful when you remove those small delicate parts from the sprue, I think that you're good. And everything seemed really nice, so I hope that everything goes together good. I will probably build this in a while. I haven't decided when, and I will probably get some paint mask for the camo scheme, or if I try to make my own using my silhouette portrait, I might do that. If nothing shows up on the aftermarket in terms of masking, I might try to do that myself. So what should I say? It looks like a really nice kit, and I'm really looking forward to building it. So with that, I want to say thank you for watching, and happy modeling, and I see you in the next one. Goodbye.